हेलो
हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू गाइडिंग वॉइस पॉडकास्ट सीरीज द गाइडिंग वॉइस फॉर ए बेटर फ्यूचर। दिस पॉडकास्ट इज टू हेल्प स्टूडेंट्स एंड यंग प्रोफेशनल्स टू शेप देयर करियर्स। थैंक यू फॉर ट्यूनिंग इन। दिस इज नवीन एंड आई एम विद माय को-होस्ट सुधाकर। डियर लिसनर्स, बिफोर वी गेट इनटू टुडेस एपिसोड, वी वुड लाइक टू एक्नॉलेज फ्यू ऑफ आवर ऑडियंस who have been actively evangelizing our podcast series. Krishna Iyer Nandagopal, Uday Bhaskar Aripirala, Vikram Edavelli, Harshita Neta, Vinod Jella, to name a few. And thank you so much for all the followers on LinkedIn, subscribers on YouTube, and for all those who are following us actively on other social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest. Thank you so much. Also, I would like to convey special thanks to Mr. Earl Francis for his constant constructive feedback and inputs in making our conversations more effective. Thank you, Earl. Very much obliged to you. All right. So, dear listeners, in this episode, we want to cover one of the most rarely spoken topics, and that is kindness in professional organizations and its effects. And we are extremely pleased to welcome Mohar to our show today to have a conversation around the same.
Dr. Mohar Ghosh is currently working as a director of administration with a software technology company based out of Hyderabad. He has over 27 years of experience in various corporations such as Satyam, General Electric, Indian School of Business, etc. Dr. Mohar comes with a diploma in management, diploma in business administration, diploma in personal management and industrial relation, PG diploma in human resource department, PG diploma in human resource development, business English communication, Cambridge, UK, MHRM, MBA, MPhil and doctorate in management studies.
I know that's quite a lot, and we need a lot of perseverance, dedication and commitment in order to pursue those many courses. So kudos to you, Dr. Ghosh. And he is also a founder of the motivation group Generous, Gracious and Gallant. He's a motivational speaker and writer. Mohar's articles have been published in multiple national and international journals. Mohar, first of all, thank you so much for accepting our invitation, and welcome again to our show today.
Mohar, thanks for accepting our invitation and welcome again to our show today.
Thank you, Naveen and Sudhakar, for having me on this channel, the guiding voice for a better future. It is indeed my privilege and honor to be able to share some of my insights with the citizens and nation builders of tomorrow. Thank you once again.
Absolute pleasure to have you here, and I'm glad you mentioned about citizens and national builders. So that speaks about your passion towards helping people.
Mohar, let us get into our conversation. What kindness means to you?
Okay, kindness, if you ask different people, they will give their different inputs to what kindness is. But for me personally, kindness is a quality of being warm, generous, gracious, reacting to every situation with a care and concern for the other person. It is really rooted in the basic human emotion of empathy, that is being able to stand in the other person's shoes to understand where the person is coming from.
Yep.
It involves what all religions really teach us, treating everyone just the way that you would like to be treated. That is with respect, fairness, compassionate, and in a friendly manner. It is all about being able to understand the diversity in the world and enjoy the diversity. It is a very critical skill in the business environment today. Science has shown that it makes a major difference in not only your own well-being, but also in the well-being of the organization and the people you interact with. Kindness starts with you. You have to understand that if you have to be kind, you first have to be kind to yourself. Because if you are kind to yourself and you are living with integrity and you are able to view yourself in the mirror every morning, it will reflect in your thoughts and your thoughts will reflect in your actions and behaviors towards others. So kindness basically starts with you.
Mm-hmm.
If you go for a clinical definition of kindness as per Wikipedia, it is a behavior marked by ethical characteristics, a pleasant disposition, concerns and consideration for others,
mm-hmm.
a virtue and a value shown by expressing concern for the welfare of others.
Mm-hmm.
In a simple word, do unto others as you would like to have others do unto you.
Absolutely wonderful thoughts, Mohar. So first thing is being warm to others, and second one, we have to appreciate the diversity, and third point that you mentioned is very, very valid. Treat others in the way you would like to be treated. Thank you for those wonderful insights.
How can we instill kindness among people starting from childhood?
Sure, Naveen and Sudhakar. So let me start by telling you that a human being is born with kindness. It is inherent in the system itself.
Mm-hmm.
So it is only a matter of reinforcing this inherent kindness in our children. How as parents go about doing that? Children are very moldable. They come with a blank slate, but with inherent quality of kindness. Now you can develop this. What is noticed gets developed, as you know, as per management science. So what you need to do is notice when they perform these small acts of kindness. Praise them for them,
mm-hmm.
for these acts of kindness. Keep reinforcing this behavior by rewarding them for these small acts of kindness. Then when you sit down with your family at multiple occasions, maybe breakfast, maybe lunch, maybe for a family gathering, you discuss this with your family members as to how important kindness really is and how it makes a difference to society. And one other thing I would really like to point out,
yep.
is, like I said, the children come with an impressionable mind and they will not only do what you say, but more importantly, they will repeat what you do. That is, you are the role model for them. Their mind is a blank slate. So if you practice kindness, you practice daily small acts of kindness, of gratitude, of caring, of being concerned towards others, and you be a role model for them, they will learn it automatically. It is a matter of being a role model and reinforcing their kind behaviors. Automatically, the upcoming generation will learn kindness.
I think you brought up a very interesting and another insightful observation, saying that children come with blank slate and they passively observe their parents and elders at home. So in case if elders demonstrate kindness, so that will get imbibed in the child's mind and child will also start adapting kindness.
Absolutely.
Very well put through, Mohar. Thank you so much. Now let us talk about a different aspect. When it comes to the organizations, how can organizations adapt or cultivate the culture of kindness?
Sure. So here I would like to start by saying it all starts with you. You cannot change the world. You can change yourself. And organizations is made up of people. What is an organization? It is a gathering of people.
Yeah.
Now, when you start with you, you start practicing kindness and you become a role model, you will initiate the process of change. You can start small. How can you become a role model? It's easy to say, but how do you start? So I have some examples. One part is active listening. Listening to what the other person is saying with full attention. Being authentic. Being clarifying where you are coming from always. Then starting a process of sharing and caring in the workplace. It starts with your immediate colleague, your neighbor in the workspace. Giving freely of the time and resources which you have. An important activity which has mandated by the government also today is the CSR initiative, where companies have to give 2% of their profits towards corporate social responsibility. Take an active part in that. Drive it for your organization. Put members towards this activity. Organizations can also actively show acts of kindness by employing the physically and mentally challenged personnel in society, helping the economically backward strata of society,
yep.
ensuring that we give them a helping hand. There are various issues which you will deal with on your day-to-day basis. Always give the benefit of doubt to the other person. Look for the good in the other person. Every cloud has a silver lining. People have become nowadays very skeptical and avoid this. Rather, believe that everyone comes with a good intention and build a culture of appreciation in your team. Start with your team. Start small. appreciate everyone. Don't wait for that poor guy to resign at the age of 58, or don't wait for him to complete his service anniversary once in 5 years, 10 years as per your organization. You will tell him on his 10th year, wow, you are such a nice person, you work so hard. 9 years the guy has logged, he doesn't know. No one has told him that he is a hard worker, he has a fantastic smile, that we appreciate the way he plays his guitar, we appreciate the way he's always able to get along with people. Point out these people whenever you get an opportunity, thank them. Mm-hmm. You know, when you build circle of appreciation, organizations will become kinder. I'm not allowed to name organizations, but I have seen organizations where they have developed a culture of kindness. For example, if someone is sick and their leaves are over, these organizations are calling for people to donate their leaves so that people can continue to get treatment without having to worry about not having their salary. These are small things. These are small things which make a major difference. Insurance amounts run out during critical illnesses. Not everyone is covered for them. Not everyone can afford these critical illnesses. Organizations have powered and increased the insurance amount for them, ensured that they're able to stay at home with full salary and recover out of these critical illnesses. There are multiple things a person and organization can do, but it all starts with you. You need to start, just like for children, even in organizations, you need to become a role model for kindness.
So, brilliant thoughts. I definitely appreciate all the thoughts that have come through in terms of celebrating small wins and not waiting for a big moment to recognize somebody and appreciating somebody then and there itself in front of everyone, and at the same time being empathetic to people that are suffering or people with disability. And as a leader, probably one has to demonstrate himself and be a role model to others. Thank you for sharing such a wonderful insights. Yeah.
Naveen and Sudhakar, I also want to highlight one critical thing which is also talk of much discussion, which is the fact that we have to recognize diversity in organizations, whether it is the LGBTs, whether it is the physically challenged, mentally challenged, people of different cultures, of different skin colors. We have to make everyone feel comfortable.
Yep.
That is another very critical part for organizations.
I think, yeah, diversity is another important factor which needs to be considered. Again, thank you for sharing those wonderful insights. What do you think will be the benefits of kindness to organizations? Because many organizations involve in this corporate social responsibility activities, or some organizations tie up with government schools and they start sending their employees over the weekends for teaching. Likewise, there are many organizations which are coming forward and helping the society. So how do you think organizations are going to get benefited out of expressing this kind of kindness?
I would like to point out, Sudhakar and Naveen, that multiple researches have been done here and the results are truly astounding. It has been found that when people work together and kindness becomes a part of the organization culture, mm-hmm. the trust among the team members expands exponentially. Stephen Covey, in his book which talks about trust, has said, if you have trust, the speed with which work happens expands exponentially. If there's no trust among the team members, a work might take 2 or 3 days to complete, for example. But if the trust is there, that same work can be completed in as much as half a day max. It's a matter of trust.
Yep.
When people practice kindness, it furthers the interpersonal bonds. Trust is built, work gets done faster, much more efficiently, effectively, at a lower cost, and it results in stress reduction, physical well-being of the employee, and retention. Physical well-being and employee retention are critical for organization. There's a huge cost involved in employee going away from organization. Valuable employees go away with knowledge and ability, and to recruit new employees is a huge cost, and then train him. So if you are able to ensure that your employees do not go away and you are able to retain them, you have huge savings and benefit for the organization. And the physical well-being of the employees ensured because of stress reduction and motivation to come to work every day. And this also saves huge medical costs for the organization. So for the organization, there are multiple benefits. It's a matter of understanding how the benefits are coming, and organizations, they are aware of the benefits which happen because of kindness, are going to just jump onto the bandwagon of kindness in organizations.
Yeah, I think you have brought a new dimension to the conversation altogether in terms of relating this kindness and how it ties back to the longevity or tenure of an employee. I think you have done good amount of research and are able to put your thoughts. In fact, I have never ever thought about kindness in that perspective. So I'm glad you are talking a lot of points which are already there and which people have not noticed at all. Thank you, Mohar, again.
Thank you.
What are the benefits to someone as individual?
Say if I am part of those corporate social responsibility or if I'm part of any kindness activity. So what is in it for me?
Yeah, so let's start by saying that when you start practicing kindness, starts releasing feel-good hormones such as serotonin in your body. It gives you a high immediately and avoids critical problems like demotivation and depression, which have been in the news for multiple reasons recently. Mm-hmm. Depression has led to a lot of suicides in the recent past. It's been in the media for a lot of reasons. So when you practice kindness, oxytocin, endorphins, okay, serotonin are released in your body and it makes you feel good. It ensures it dilates your blood vessels, protects your heart, reduces your BP. You live longer. Mm-hmm. You experience a high. Your self-image improves.
Yeah.
It has benefits in controlling your weight. Weight is reduced. Cortisol, the stress factor, hormones are reduced in your body. It reduces anxiety, depression, stress, boosts happiness, enhances your self-worth. All these benefits kick in by doing acts of kindness. Study has shown by volunteering, you will build stronger associations with a larger group and community, and you lower inflammatory diseases effects on your organs, and you tend to live longer because of your stronger bonds. So many benefits. I have listed about 14-15 benefits. And a simple thing as doing what? Being kind, smiling at someone on the road, just stepping back and giving a lady the right to go in the lift first rather than you having her stand it while you go into the lift, or giving a lady a seat when you are traveling in your bus can have so many benefits. Your self-image has improved, your body is responding well, you are getting rid of depression, anxiety, you are feeling better about yourself, feel-good hormones are being released, you feel motivated, you are overcoming depression, your stress has reduced, a helper high is being experienced, you're going to live longer. All these benefits are available to you. Who would not like to jump on the bandwagon and get all these benefits in his life by simply doing a simple random act of kindness? It's amazing.
Yeah, beautiful thoughts again. So random act of kindness is something like maybe offering someone a seat or first of all greeting a stranger with a smile. Because it reminds me one other aspect, a beautiful quotation, I don't know who put it, but smile is an inexpensive way to improve your beauty, and at the same time, smile is an inexpensive gift that we can give it to someone and which is invaluable.
Absolutely, Naveen and Sudhakar, you hit it the nail bang on the head. Nature itself has designed us. Nature has designed us to be kind. For example, it takes lesser calories to smile than to sprout. It's a known fact of science. By doing random acts of kindness, there are so many benefits which are coming to your body. So what is nature telling us? Be kind. You will be kind to yourself. So many benefits will come out to you, but just by smiling at a stranger. Why would you not like to do it?
Interesting again, like in terms of number of calories that we burn when we smile versus frown are lesser, right? So yeah, very interesting thoughts.
Are there any scientifically proven benefits?
Absolutely. Multiple researches have been done on kindness and compassion and the benefits to mankind because of kindness. So I will state a few researches which have been done on this. A brain imaging study was done by the National Institute of Health, and it found that when we see money going to charity, brain pleasure centers in the are activated. It found that the brain is much happier when we give money as a charity than when money is spent on just ourselves. And this study was done by Mr. Mike Norden and published in the scientific journal. Third, it found that both men and women rated the opposite sex which practiced kindness more as more attractive. It means that more both men and women find the opposite sex more attractive when they see acts of kindness being done. So it increases attractiveness. Science has found this. Then in a study done by Mr. Jonathan Held, in the University of Virginia. It found that when we see people help each other, it brings us to a state of elevated brainwave, which is like meditation. Another study which was done by James Feller of the University of San Diego and Nicholas of Harvard University demonstrated that when you do a simple act of kindness, it spreads like wildfire. I would like to explain this further. For example, if today you smiled at me when I came at the lift, or you gave me a place and said you first and you waited, my mood has improved, so has your mood. So when I go up to my floor, I will greet the receptionist there with a nice smile and a good morning. And when I go to my chambers, on the way to my chambers, I might wish 10 other people with a smile and good morning. Now, each of these 10 people who has experienced a smile from me will feel better, and they in turn will relate better to the other and pass it on. So imagine, one act of kindness can explode and affect up to 100 people in a matter of minutes. So it spreads like wildfire, and this has been proven scientifically by the University of San Diego. It boosts health and longevity, reduces stress and worry. Michael Translow and other scientists have found that what I had discussed earlier, that kindness is a state of natural being. That means kindness reflects naturally in the human body. Another thing, it has found that when you spend time and money volunteering, the effect is that you find more time and money in your own life. And scientifically, it has been proved that kindness has an effect on society, community, and the environment. So multiple studies, some of which I have referred to here, have proved that kindness is and will always make a difference to the humankind. And I would like to reiterate once again the message that science has found that kindness is the natural state of mankind. The human body, the human brain is designed to react and give positive outcomes to acts of kindness. It is nature's way of telling us, be kind.
I think that's quite a lot of research that you have done and provided us with facts and figures in terms of how kindness is going to boost positivity. It also has a ripple effect on other people that we come across. And if we are joyful, we are able to spread the joy to few others.
Absolutely.
So yeah, thank you for amazing thoughts again.
Absolutely.
It was a great conversation so far, and I'm loving the conversation. So in the interest of time, can you quickly talk about any personal tips that you'd like to share with our audience?
Sure. For me, what I found really useful is maintaining a kindness list. This is the list where I note down 10-15 things, and I keep expanding this list as you grow on your path of kindness. It's small things which you can do on a daily basis, which can quickly be done on a daily basis. For example, I have got it in my kindness list that I must smile when I enter a lift and wish people. So these are small changes which can be done in your lifestyle. So it's important to maintain a list. Start small with small things. Like what? Smile at your neighbor. Smile at the people in your bus, in the lift. It's a lifestyle stage. So you have to take small steps, and then you can go on to bigger things. Be a role model for this in your community, in your organization, and share these lifestyle changes with your circle. Try and expand the circle of kindness. Share the circle of kindness. That will make a major difference in your life and in the life of others.
Wonderful thoughts. I completely love the conversation, and I'm sure Sudhakar will concur with that. So thank you so much, Mohar. We really appreciate you being here and sharing a lot of insights around kindness and the benefits that someone is going to have for himself or herself, and how it is going to impact the organization, so on and so forth. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for accepting our invitation despite your busy schedule.
Thank you, Sudhakar and Naveen. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure to be able to share my thoughts with the community. I'm really grateful to you and Sudhakar for giving me this opportunity to share my thoughts on kindness. Thank you so much.
It's our pleasure, Mohar. And again, appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule and joining us on this show. And I'm sure our listeners are going to enjoy every bit of our conversation today. All right. So, dear listeners,
to know more about our speaker and content, visit or follow us on social media, or feel free to email us, and we will be happy to share further details with you.
All right. So, it brings us to the trivia segment of this episode. And today's trivia is related to sarcasm. Sarcasm is not treated positively or taken easy by everyone. But, you know, according to a 2015 study, it was found that sarcasm can promote creative thinking. So that's why if you notice some of the directors or somebody whoever is into creative field, they are very sarcastic. So I hope you love the trivia segment. If you'd like to share any trivias, please feel free to share them through email. And our email address is theguidingvoiceforyou@gmail.com or SMS us or text us at India number 9494587187. We will not only share best trivias in future episodes, we will also announce your names. Again, we are open for suggestions on topics that you'd like to hear from us through our email address. Our email address is theguidingvoice4u@gmail.com. You may also WhatsApp us on our India number 9494587187. Like our page on Facebook, facebook.com/theguidingvoice4u, or follow us on Twitter, twitter.com/guidingvoice. To stay tuned about our future episodes, we are also available on Instagram as The Guiding Voice for You. Also, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/c/theguidingvoice. There is more in store. Until next time, have a wonderful time. Thank you for listening. Take care and be safe.